This is John Johnson for KPBX-FM, and welcome to Johnson's Improbable History of Pop. Howard Dwayne Allman was born November 20th, 1946, in Nashville, Tennessee. A year later, brother Greg followed him into the world. They were raised by their single-parent mother after their father was killed in an early 50s robbery by a hitchhiker. Dwayne was initially taught guitar by Greg. By 1961, both brothers were playing in local bands in the Daytona Beach, Florida area. Early influences included electrified Chicago blues bands and James Brown. By 1965, the brothers were playing high-powered white boy rhythm and blues as the Allman Joys. A year later, their first studio recordings were made, with Dwayne, even then, displaying a dazzling virtuosity bred by years of intense practice and improvisation. In 1967, the band was centered in Los Angeles and recording the first of two albums as Hourglass. By late 1969, the group had evolved into the Allman Brothers Band and recorded their first album for Atlantic Records as Dwayne's skills continued to mature. It was a rapid ride for Dwayne Allman, and he became known as something of a fast life writer, which is the title for tonight's program. And with us to share knowledge of and some very interesting music by Dwayne Allman is Ben Upham of Spokane. Ben is a longtime fan and collector of Dwayne Allman's music. He's been a guest for various episodes of this program. And in talking off mic, Ben, I understand we'll be concentrating primarily this evening on Dwayne Allman as a guitar player.
Yes, that's really his strong point. I do have some very, very rare vocals to share this evening with us that have never been released. But his real strong point, I feel, is his slide work. And so, therefore, I've kind of dug for some rarities and some gems that showcase this.
What makes his playing so special for you? I mean, that's a tough general question, but what about Dwayne?
I think the thing that really grabs me is the tone. Something about the tonal qualities that he reaches grabs me. And like I heard that one of his tricks to getting such an unusual tone was that he would used weak batteries in some of his floor toys, and for his guitar. He would have batteries that were halfway shot, and it would change the sound of the tone.
By design?
Yes, he discovered this quite by accident at one point and liked the results, and therefore he would always test his batteries before a show and make sure they were low.
I think the story is that he was inspired to play slide guitar by the first Taj Mahal album, which featured two great slide players on it, Ry Cooder and Jesse Ed Davis.
Yes, I had heard that, and I think Dwayne took things that he heard to brand new heights. He used things that he had heard in more of a blues format and brought them into blues and jazz and rock like nobody else ever had. And you know, if you listen to a lot of work that's been done since Dwayne Allman's untimely death in 1971, you realize that the medium of slide guitar has come a long way. But in listening to these old tapes and these old recordings, you realize at the time a lot of this was real fresh sounding and brand new. And it's incredible when you think that Dwayne Allman died at age 24, had almost appeared on nearly 40 albums at that time as a session man.
Well, we'll get into that aspect a bit later. What is it we're going to be hearing first?
For the first selection, I thought we might as well jump into something really, really good. This is a version of Dreams that was recorded at the Field House in Columbia, Missouri, in February 28th, 1971.
And this is with the Allman Brothers Band.
That is correct.
Right at their peak. Very good. Let's get to it.